Rolling, 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 rolling on the river, rolling down the Mississippi. Welcome, everybody, to WIM Wednesdays here at B-Side. Yeah, hi. We would like to welcome everyone from near and far. We are here every last Wednesday of the month here at B-Side, and WIM stands for Women in Memphis Music. And tonight is a very special episode, I guess, or, you know, show for us, because today, or this month, is the 2-year anniversary of Women in Memphis Music, and all this, yeah. 2 years. In those 2 years, we've hosted over 50 local female musicians. That's, yeah. And if this is the first time you're here, I just want to let you know that some of the fiercest musicians in the world are from Memphis, Tennessee. Hello. And you can check our archive. It's on Women in Memphis Music on our YouTube page, and you can follow us on our Instagram page, and you can also follow us on our Facebook page. So however you found us and however you got here, we're happy that you're here. We promise you a very amazing show tonight. We have Empress Joyce and the Corps is here. And Foster Falls is here. And Miss Megan May is here. So the way that this night goes, we have 3 bands tonight. Also, we usually only have 2, but tonight we have 3. So you really came on an extra special night. After this first set by Megan, and I'm going to tell you a little bit about her in just 1 second, we're going to have all the female musicians come up, and we're going to do a little interview. And I also want to say that there's also cake here tonight. You guys like cake? Cake is always good. So let me give you a little bit of a background on our first performer this evening. Megan May is a country blues artist from Jackson, Mississippi. Her 2024 independent debut album, Bentonia Voodoo Queen, which is out now, was recorded right here in Memphis. She is the apprentice of Bentonia bluesman Jimmy Duck Holmes and resides in Bentonia, Mississippi, playing frequently at the historic Blue Front Cafe. Tonight, she will be accompanied by fellow Mississippi musician, multi-instrumentalist, and instrument builder, R.L. Superbad. So please give a warm, warm welcome to Miss Megan May.
I've been wanting to play at B-Side for it actually marks the 2 years since I started my journey in Memphis as well, making this record. So thank you for letting me be a part of this. It's wonderful. Yeah.
Cheers.
All right, Ariel.
When you can't play it like you used to,
when you can't howl at the full moon,
and your heart stops beating right out of the clear blue, oh, who do you come crying to? Where do you go?
Guns and horses.
Guitar. He makes these instruments, by the way. He's coming up from Clarksville, Mississippi tonight. Very proud to be here playing with him. Again, my name is Megan May. Did just release a record called Bentonia Voodoo Queen. So y'all, check it out if you haven't heard it yet. Footsteps as you walk. Are you broke down up the road or deep inside? Can I have a little more guitar in this monitor, please, of my guitar? Did your car run out of gas? Your left front tire blow. Fears get scrambled in the bottom of your soul. Are you broke down up the road or deep inside? That hotbed roadside river gravel done way up in my shoe. That ball of fire near burned me slap alive. Inside. Been in the arms since they threw you at a
decade and a half. Skin and mules, are you broke down up the road or deep inside? That hot bed roadside rhythm and gravel done way up in my shoe. Did your mama always tell you no? Did your dad? Your brothers and your sisters told you lies. Well, I remember that Sunday morning when a man made off with your tools. Are you broke down up the road or deep inside?
That's called Broke Down Up the Road. It's a good driving song. It's called Chevy Truck. We wanted to live a dream, leave a legacy that means something. We drove to the land's ending. Stars sparkled in the canyons like I'd never seen. But now I gotta put California and Silver Beach and mountains far behind me with you by my side. Let's put truck and drive from Barstow to Albuquerque, Amarillo, you and our little girl. We can't leave my guitar or that picture of you and your grandma. Truck and drive.
might save a life and keep this little town out of mind and out of sight. No one would hate me because I can't tell them about you.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you. That's called Chevy Truck.
Well, I'm on a plane to Portland. You're on a train to New Orleans. Well, I pass that shady grove. Jesse Romper's calling me. Been told you ever do queen. Queen, she must have seen the devil in her dream.
Can I have some more guitar, please?
Well, you show up on my front porch with flowers on. Well, I've gone to see my auntie and get that feeling she got there. Been told you ever do queen. Thank you. you're so good looking, baby. The devil.
That's called Bentonia Voodoo Queen, followed up by Bentonia Blues song, The Devil. Thank y'all for having me tonight. I made this record in Memphis. It's got Memphis in its blood.
Yeah, thank you.
RL Superbad, thank you.
Is this one on? Oh, it's on now. Here I was like yelling at everyone, and it's on. All right, while we take a second just to get adjusted and everything, I do want to mention for anybody out there or anybody out here, we have an event tomorrow night. We have this wonderful, wonderful organization here in Memphis called Music Export Memphis. And musicians from Memphis can get financial help on vinyl, merchandise, if they go on tour. So we have an informational session at the Cossett Library, which is also a huge wealth of resources for artists in this city. We're gonna be there tomorrow night, 6:30 to 8:30. So anybody that's tuned in watching or anybody out there trying to go on tour and trying to do your thing, let Music Export Memphis help you. All right, oh good, you pulled it off there. All right, do you wanna? It's all good. I mean, if you can hold it if you need to. Like your security, it's just security guitar. I gotcha. So first of all, I want to know, how did everybody get started in music? I mean, I guess if you're from Memphis, it's like you just drink the water and you're like, woo, I got it. But If you're not, or what made you go this route? Make sure you talk into the mic as well, so everybody.
Family. Family. That's what we did on the porch.
I was like, they made you go into music, or you? Yes. You were like, I like math. They were like, no.
That's what we all did. Was sat around the house, you know, on the weekends and play guitar and sang songs. And awesome. My mom was a gospel singer, so you know, that's in the country. There's not a lot to do either. So that's what we did for entertainment and being together.
Awesome.
Well, I guess being from the South, my story probably pretty much the same. Started out in the church. My father's a pastor, and you know, just born with it and just kind of ran with it, and hopefully my gift will continue to make room for me, and yeah, that's why we're here.
Awesome.
I was very hyperverbal as a child, and as I grew, I found that people would listen to me more if I did it with a little music behind it, and I could get my message across a little easier. And people would remember it a little better if it was sung. So yeah,
I totally can relate to that. Cause I'll be talking, and then I go like this, and they're like, "What is this like opera singing, like talking that you do?" And I'm like, "Well, I feel like it makes a lasting impact." I don't know. All right, we've got 18 questions. You guys are gonna each pick one. So pick a number 1 through 18, and Empress, you can go first.
Six.
Well, she was like, "I know what I'm picking."
I do.
All right. Oh, wait, hold on. I got to get to the right ones. Lord. All right. Can you recall any specific times you asked for help?
Like in my career? Yes and no, because I'm still working on learning how to ask for help because I'm the helper. But, yeah, I can remember some times, like definitely when I first got started, I asked for help, and even now, I still ask for help. The founder of the core band, he helps me a lot with even my musicianship now. So I'm learning now to X. You see what I'm saying? So I'm getting better at it.
Yeah. It's a hard thing to ask for help. I know, I get it. Same question. Do you want me to repeat it?
I put y'all in there, didn't I?
Will you?
Yeah. Can you recall any specific times you asked for help?
In the music business?
Yeah, in your career as a musician.
Yes, when I met Kari Wynn in Memphis, Tennessee.
I know him very well.
Yes, I asked him for help. Will you help me? I want to record this on my own. And musicians in Memphis, Tennessee showed up and helped me make this record. And I was happy that I asked for help.
Yeah.
Yeah. Real friends.
You asked one of the best. I'm just saying. I'm a little biased. Yes. I like that. But it's true. I've also found that the musicians here are very supportive and very helpful, which is a big difference from where I came from, New York City. So, yay, Memphis. Can you recall any specific time you asked for help?
Yeah. So, if y'all don't know me, I'm Foster. I go by they, them pronouns. I'm non-binary, but I have frequently asked for and received help from some of the wonderful women in Memphis music. This is such a cool platform. And Kathy, who will be up here shortly, playing
WIM alumni.
Keys with me. Yes, WIM alumna. She has given me so much help in like learning just the ins and outs of like booking practices, and as well as just helping me to write some beautiful music. So that's definitely a time that I've gained a lot from asking for help from some women in Memphis music.
I love it. Like they say, closed mouths don't get fed. All right. I know, right? Someone said to me, oh, I like that saying. I'm going to use it. You go ahead and pick a number 1 through 18, Megan.
Number 3.
Are you sure? No, I'm just kidding. Yeah, what things did you have to let go of or leave behind in order to take the leap?
I just quit my job 3 weeks ago.
Okay, that is pretty big. Nice, that takes guts.
Having like 5 different degrees from school, and none of them are in music, but I've been pursuing music only for over 10 years. And
wow.
this is the only source of income. So, and yeah,
right
having
on.
Kids and all, yeah. So, big leap of faith. So, yeah, we not working, but this is the work, yeah, that we putting in.
I love it, yeah.
I feel like I had to let go of a lot of perfectionism. I'm definitely one of those people who won't start something unless I know I'm going to be able to do it the right way. And there's really no right way with music and with being a creative, so for sure.
That brings me to another saying by Arthur Ashe, and I'm probably getting this out of order, but it's three things. Start where you are, use what you can, and do what you are. Use what you have, start where you are, and use what you can, or something. But it's like, it's the thing. It's like, just do it,
just
right?
Yeah.
Yes,
yeah.
I love that. Snap, snap, snap. All right, 1 through 18, you get to pick a number.
18.
Wow, okay. Name something that you did that you considered a failure. What did you learn from it, and do you still consider it a failure? Only asking the hard questions here. Come on, we're getting to the meat of it.
Take a second, because I know.
So in college, I made a mix CD and like distributed it, just like handed it out to some friends. And I look back and I listen to some of those songs and I'm like, ugh, like it's grating. I made all of them in Audacity. They don't sound very good, but that was the first time that I ever tried to like mix my own music, and I've learned so much since then, and I would not have started had I not just done what I could with what I had at the time. So
I love that. Nice. All right.
I started making my record about 13 years ago, and it didn't work out, and so I had these amazing tracks and songs, and I couldn't get the files. And so there were many nights where I laid awake in bed, and I'm like, what have I done to deserve this? And my songs, but they're still my songs. So I thought it was a failure that I didn't make the record 13 years ago, but then it turned out I ended up recording something so much better. So yeah, it makes us... It's a cliche for a reason. It's a good one, you know. It makes us who we are now. So.
Yeah, exactly. If you learn from it. Otherwise, you're going to keep repeating things until you do.
Man. Oh, okay. I guess I don't know if I consider it necessarily a failure, but I would say it was definitely a learning tool for me. I actually got accepted to go to Broadway when I was like 21. But my daughter did special needs at the time. I had no one to care for her. Mm-hmm. And so I had to make the decision, am I going to just up and move to California, or am I going to stay to be able to take care
right.
of my child and get the resources that I need and still pursue independently? And so that's what I decided to do, you know. And so I don't consider that a failure, because being around to raise my daughter has been nothing but, you know, it's been successful, of course, because that's my child. And
right.
I feel like I made the best decision, because I'm still doing music and opportunities are still coming. So it's more of just a learning lesson, just a pivotal moment in my career.
Nice. Mm-hmm. I love it. All right. Anybody out there have any questions for them? Don't be shy. Yes.
I feel like it changes based on the song, but a lot of my stuff, I guess, is centered around this idea of like self-examination not being a bad thing. And I feel like a lot of people, it's kind of painful to look inward sometimes, and it's kind of painful to wade through the things that drive you when they're unexamined. And once you have done that, you have so much more opportunity to really curate, like, not only your actions, but what's motivating them. And that creates such a different type of drive towards the outcomes that you want.
Yeah, nice.
It's hard to say. It's hard to say. If it weren't for music, I'd be dead for sure. So I think the biggest message is that we are all the same. We're all human, and it doesn't matter where we come from or what language we speak, but music brings us together. And at the heart, we're all the same. Yes. So we have to love each other.
Yes. Spread love.
Yes, most definitely. I'm going to piggyback off of them because it's true. As a musician, I feel like my music has changed with my age, with the times, with the recording equipment that we have access to, because y'all know we may have started recording in the bathroom closets, in the living rooms, you know, all of those different things, but now we have, you know, A-track, you got to get it right the first time, it's no overdub and none of that. So just to, I left a status one time where I put Amy Winehouse, Whitney Houston, Empress Joyce, you know, because I pull from both of those ladies, and I feel like the human experience that I've experienced, like she said, that's why I'm here. You know, music is what gives me life, and music is what has brought a lot of those things together with people and things and places and situations, whether they're good, bad, ugly, or indifferent. So it's like to be able to be standing here doing what we love. You know, sometimes that's all we need, and, you know, we're just pushing through it.
I hear that. All right. Anybody else have any questions? All right, this is the fire round. Those were the easy ones. Now, these are the hard ones, because these are the ones that I wrote. All right, we're going to fire away here. All right. Wait, I just had them. What did I do with them? Oh, here we go. What is one of your favorite bands that people would be surprised you liked?
Exactly. Def Leppard.
That's a killer song.
Bone Thugs and Harmony.
I know. Who can rap that fast? All right.
I don't know. What would you be surprised if I like?
Well, actually, because I'm, you know, hearing your music, I don't know. Like, I don't want to give too much away. But, you know, you have, like, this vibe. It's, like, it was very reminiscent of, like, Joni Mitchell. And so if you were to come out and be like, actually, Slayer is my favorite band, I'd probably be a little bit shocked.
Yeah. I'm going to be really honest. I don't listen to a lot of music anymore. Like, because when I'm in a creating music phase, I feel like it kind of distracts me and, like, makes it so that I can't. So I guess that's surprising, as I'm like, I'm out here making music, and I'm like, well, I don't really listen to music that much.
As long as you're making the music that you want to listen to, then that's all. That's all you need. All right. What was your favorite breakfast cereal as a kid?
Our favorite breakfast cereal?
Yeah. I miss Golden Grahams.
Yes. Corn flakes and bananas.
Did you put sugar on it?
That's right.
Did you put sugar on it?
That's right.
Yeah.
We're from the country. Got okay, that's all.
All right, just making sure.
I was a Cinnamon Toast Crunch enjoyer. Oh. That's a good one.
Count Chocula.
Oh, I don't even think they make that anymore. All right. The last one, you guys. You made it till the final round.
Dun, dun, dun.
If you were a superhero, what would your superpower be?
Telekinesis.
Nice.
Oh my goodness. Oh, I would be a mom superhero. Everybody clean up after themselves and wash their own dishes.
Yeah. Nice.
Oh, I would be a songwriting machine.
Okay.
Yeah.
There you go. Super songwriter.
Yeah.
All right, cool. You guys, give them a hand. Those questions were hard. Thank you so much. All right, good job, you guys. Good job. All right, we're going to take a short break, and we're going to switch over the stage, and then I'm going to tell you a little bit about Foster Falls, so just hang on for a few more minutes. And one other thing I'm just going to say, you know, it's Women's Month, y'all. Like, we're almost at the end of, right. Give it up for the women. along with it being Women's Month, I just want to say to any of the young boys or young men out there that thank God for modern medical technology that you too can also grow up to be a woman. Just saying. That's how it is these days, right? Women are so awesome and they're like, I want to be, but you can now because technologically and scientifically, we have done it. All right, who wants cake? That's what I thought. All right, hang tight, guys. We'll be back in a few minutes. All right. Are we ready, Joe?
Yeah, we're rolling.
Oh, we're rolling, rolling, rolling. All right, cool. Welcome back, everybody. Hope everybody had a little bit of a sugar rush there. All right, we've got Foster Falls coming up. Foster Falls weaves introspective lyrics, ethereal harmonies, into dreamy stripped-down arrangements that bring you into a world where clarity arises from self-observation and lush vegetation. She is joined tonight by a WIM alumni, Ms. Kathy Zhao, on keys. So please put your hands together for Foster Falls.
I'm Foster. My pronouns are they, them. You can find me on the internet at Foster Falls. Kathy at KZ Music. And Kathy, thank you for being the designated woman in Memphis music for our set. Appreciate y'all so much. Anybody who has seen me play before probably knows this story. I grew up around the corner from this church, and one summer the church letterboard said, "If you think it's hot now, just wait." So I lost my soul early in a drive-by damnation. I felt a leaf to my feet and my hands got cold. I took one for the team and I called it a day. Up and away it floated, but no one ever cut the string. Together. Shout out to women. They're so cool.
Space.
Today, so I'm going to tune up real quick. This next song that we're about to play is about a dream I had where I sword fought my inner child. And after that, I like went into this chamber and convinced my inner child that like you didn't need to do violence or use force to have power. And then there was this sword that I had brought with me, and I wanted to keep the same sword, but there was this like angel character who was trying to give me a different sword, and I was like, no, I want my old sword. And that became a problem when I finally got the old sword back, and this scroll unfurled and like listed all of the butterfly effect consequences that were gonna happen because I took my old sword. And then I realized that all of my choices in the dream had impact, and I guess my inner child realized that too. And then we went on this quest. We were still going on the quest, you know, I just had to move on. All those consequences were gonna happen anyway. And we went on this quest and we reached this beautiful garden, and there was this woman in the garden in this like bounty who was just like weeping and like pulling up these bountiful plants at their roots. And so yeah, this is called The Interpreter.
Images in me.
much. This one's called Listless. It's actually out. Thank you all so much. Another one I wrote with Kathy, so shout out to women again. Thank you.
the back of the line until your quotas.
This is another one that's out. Jason played on this track, so excited to have him here doing some trumpet. Sing along.
Thank you.
for today. So much. We got two more for you, and then we'll head out and give the stage over to Empress Joyce and the Corps. Texture's different. Does that keep you up at night? Thank you. tune up one more time. Anybody been longing for spring lately? That's what this one's about. I wish there was a spring without the excess pollen. Spring sans allergies would be ideal to me. The like yellow blanket over everything is not my favorite part.
Keep it going for Foster Falls. All right, you guys, we've got one final act left. We're going to take a short little break, and we're going to switch over to the stage. All right.
Selections I'm gonna be doing for y'all. They are originals. I like to do something that I call rhythm hop because I like to move around a little bit when I'm on stage. So I'm gonna try to stand here as much as I can, but y'all still, y'all move for me, okay? Now that was rhythm hop. Y'all give it up. Now that's the intro to my latest album, 30 Plus. Yeah, because I like to just get it started, get your juices flowing, okay? Now this next song is If anybody know me personally, y'all know I'm a very eccentric person. So I wrote a song about it, all about me, and all about some people that I know, because I know I'm not the only one. How many bipolar people we got in here? Everybody's hand need to be up, okay? So I wrote a song about it called Bipolar Mind. For this band one time, two times. Woo, thank y'all. See, y'all get hot up here on these stage, but look, it's all worth it, baby. So listen, this song right here is also an original. Just shot a video to this song that I'm about to perform this weekend, so y'all look out for that. It's entitled Waiting. My girls out there, this is one of their favorite songs. I'm mostly known for R&B, but I do all genres, from country to gospel to opera, whatever it is, I can sing it. So y'all just listen to the song. Now when we started out, everything was good. I did my thing, you did your thing, and it was understood. Somewhere along the way, things had changed.
Yeah.
Y'all give it up for the band one time, two times. It's not always easy playing original music. You feel what I'm saying?
Now when we started out, everything was good.
Yeah.
for me.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Man, this sound amazing. Y'all, I'm having a good time. Y'all having a good time? So, y'all, guess what? We are halfway through the set. So, I'm going to get a little drink while they getting ready to, yeah. How many Adele fans we got in the house?
This one of my favorite songs by her.
Sometimes I be wanting people to just take it easy on me sometimes. Give me a little grace.
Thank you.
Thank you all so much. I have to hold my emotions back. It's hard for us to not cry sometimes on stage, and I'm a big cry baby. So I like to do medleys, old school meets new school. So we finna do a medley, old school meets new school. And then our last song, we gonna turn up in here. And I just need to see, this my last song, if I don't see no shoulders wiggling and some feet patting, I'm just telling y'all, okay? Thank you. Okay, so we gonna smooth it out and we gonna turn it up. Y'all ready? Are y'all ready? Okay.
The sun, the rain, the moon, the stars, and the mountains. I'll give you the world and all that you reach for, and even more. 'Cause boy, I love you more than you could know, and that's for sure.
Now this is our last song of the night. Have y'all enjoyed the core band? Okay, okay.
Y'all know that real.
Now you know, every now and then, we like to do stuff nice and easy. You know why? Do you know why?
Why?
Because we always doing things nice and rough. So we gonna slow it down for you. And we gonna do it nice and easy. But we gonna finish it rough. Is that all right? Is that all right? Okay. if y'all know it, sing along. And we're rolling, yeah. Rolling on a river. Listen, I left a good job down in the city, working for the man every night and day, and I never lost one minute of sleep, cause I was worried about the way things might have been.
Oh, no.
Y'all give it up for this band. Thank you all so much.
Oh my goodness. Thank you so much to everybody that came out tonight. Thank you, Megan May. Thank you, Foster Falls. It's bringing the Fire Empress Joyce and the core. Thank you, B-Side, Joe, John, and Taku all
you.
The time. We will see you next month. Coco and the Hitmen are going to be here along with Window. Thank you so much for coming out tonight. We will see you.